What's up, guys? Dr. Jody Hierholzer here, physical therapist with Bodyworks PT. And today we're going to show you guys the Beighton screen. The Beighton screen is a flexibility screen that we can use to tell if we are on the hypermobile side or the hypomobile side. And all that means is, are we overly flexible? Are we underly flexible? So you can kind of give yourself a little screen to see where you're at based on joints. We're going to look at wrist and hand. We're going to look at elbow, low back and knees today. So I've got Macy here to help me out with this screen. So the Beighton scale is going to be on a 9-point screen. The first thing we're going to look at are her elbows. So I'm going to have Macy hold her arms out for me. And if you look at her elbow joint, she's going to be breaking the plane right there. What we'd like to see is that elbow stops at about neutral. But because she gets beyond neutral, we're going to call that a point, and we're going to call the right arm a point. So right now she's 2 out of 9 towards the overly flexible side. So now we're going to look at her hands. I'm going to have you step up a little bit here, Macy. She's going to take her hand, hold it out flat, and I want her to try to take her pinky back for me as far as she can with her other hand. And we're looking to see, does she break 90-degree angle here? And she does not. So that's a pass. So she doesn't get a point for that one, which is a good thing. Let's do the same thing on the other hand. And again, on the left hand, same thing. Doesn't really break that 90-degree angle. That's a pass, no point there. So right now she's 2 for 4. We're gonna look at her thumbs now. She's gonna take her thumb and try to push that thumb towards her forearm. So let's see what we got here. She cannot, you guys can see there, get her thumb to the forearm. That's a good thing. Same thing on the left side. And good, no problem there. So right now the only positive we have are hypermobile elbows. Now we're gonna look at her low back. So I'm gonna have Macy step back for me. She's gonna turn to the side. And I'm gonna have her bend forward, and I'm gonna stand right back here. So she's gonna try to bend forward to touch the ground with 2 flat hands. Let's see if she can do that. So she's gonna bend forward. Notice she can maybe touch them with her fingertips, but she's not getting her hands flat on the ground. So she's not overly hyperflexible in the low back or in the hamstrings there, okay? One more test we're gonna look at are her knees. So take a small step forward for me. I'm gonna cue the patient, hey, just push your knees back as far as you can. So she's gonna push back on those knees. And you guys can see she breaks that straight plane. We wanna see just straight line up and down, 0 degrees is what we call that. But she goes beyond that, and so we've got some hypermobility in her knees. So Macy's gonna get a score of 1 more there. I'm gonna have her turn and face the other way so you guys can see her left leg. She's also hypermobile on her left leg, so another point there. So Macy scored a 4 out of 9. She's got 2 points on her elbows, 2 points on her knees. That puts her somewhere in the middle when we talk about if somebody's either overly flexible or underly flexible. It's not really a pass-fail, it just tells us more information. So if you wanna check yourself out, screen your joints, see, hey, am I on that flexible side or not flexible side, give it a go. It's called the Beighton scale. Let us know how you do.